In this video, we are going to see basic SQL commands, which helps you to do execute the commands in PHP script. Okay, so first we will see some very few basic commands. Now, how to create a tables? The keyword is create table, and this is optional. If not exists, if optional, then you have to give the table name along with that. Within bracket, you can give column list, and each column, what type of data type, each column that also has to be mentioned. So for example, here is an example, create table. If not exists, this is only optional. Okay. So if it is not present, then it will create. If it exists, it will post an error that table already exists. Now, so if create table, then st table, as again I am saying, this is not necessary. St table, that is the name of the table, this is given by the user, so user defined variable only. That is then the name of the column and what type column it is, whether it is an integer, floating point, varchar, the text, like that. So here we give it as integer, student ID to be integer, and not null. When I say not null, which means the user must enter the data. It should not be left without entering any data. Okay. It should not be left blank. So user has to enter the data. That's why that's the meaning of the not null. So if the not null is specified along with this column, then the database will stick to that the user must enter some data. Then name, which is of type varchar, 20, that is both character, that is it you can enter character as well as you can enter the integer. So it's a string type. And again, here we make it as not null, that is name must be entered, should not be left blank. Then age, department ID. Here next to the age, we have given what data type it is. Same way here, primary key. Now, what is this primary key? So already you have studied in database management system that primary key is a key which uniquely identifies each record in the database. Okay, so here what we make is, we cannot make student name to be a primary key because the same name may occur again and again. Many students may have the same name. So in that case, it is not a right choice. So better, student ID will be unique. So you can select that to be a primary key. So you have to type it like this, primary key. In caps, and then within the bracket, which is acting as a primary key, that has to be given. So once it is given, now it will say query. Okay, but all these things, if it is if you are expressing this in a Ubuntu terminal, but the same thing can be given for the Windows based MySQL also. Other way also you can do, you can use PHP MyAdmin, within which it allows you to enter the, create the database and create the table, etc. That also can be done through user interface. Also it can be done. Now what I am telling is how to enter this, how to create this through terminal. That's what we are seeing now, the full keyword we are seeing. Now if you want to describe the table, what is meant by describe the table? When I give describe, then the table name, it will show you the what is the field name of the table, and then types, that the null fields are what are all the null fields, and if it say no, then this is not a null field. Okay, then here these are all null fields. Age, the user no need to enter age, no need to enter department. Even if he doesn't enter these two day fields, it will allow him to save the data, but here it is not like that. They have to enter the data. Then here primary key, PRI, which says this is a primary key, and default value, they are all null. So a describe along with the table name will help you to show the metadata of the table. Then altering table structure. Once I have created this table, I may want to add some more column. Okay, I may want to modify this field. That is student ID is the field name, and I may want to modify the data type. So for doing all these things, we can go for altering table. Once the table is created, we may want to modify some of its features. So in that case, we can go for the altering table structure. So what is the syntax? Altering Then table, table name, options. So what are the options? You can add a column. So because here we have four columns, I can add a fifth column by using this alter. So alter, table, table name, add, then you have to give the column name and what data type it is, etc. And you can give first and after. Say for example, I may want to insert the particular column between student ID and student name. So in that case, I can mention first or after this column, like that I can give. Or add column, all these things, or add an index, add a primary key. Suppose I have created this table without creating any primary key. That also can be done. That is, in this, it is not necessary that you have to give this primary key. So once it is created, after sometimes I find that I must give a primary key. In that case also, we can add a primary key using alter table. Add primary key, then you have to give which column you want to make it as a primary key. Same way, add unique, full text, then foreign key. You may want to add a foreign key. So that also can be done. Then alter the column, change, modify a particular column. Even the name also you can say. Then if you want to delete a particular column, say for example, I don't want this age column to be here. I can remove that column by using the drop column, column name, then drop primary key. So once I set a primary key, after some time I may want to set another key as a primary key. So before doing that, I have to drop the previous primary key, drop the column which is mentioned as a primary key. It is not actually a dropping the column, dropping the columns, setting as primary key. So once it is done, that column will be relieved from the primary key. Then I can make any other column to be a primary key. Then drop index, disable keys, all these things can be done with the alter keyword. So normally we use the change and modify are the same. They allow you to change the definition of the column or its position in the table. The drop column will drop the column from the table permanently. Okay, the rename column, if I want to change the table name to another one, that can be also done by using the rename. So for example, I have given here as ST table. I want to give full name as student table. If I want to rename, I can rename by using the rename option. Then deleting the file. To delete a table completely, then you can give drop table. Then you can drop the values. Here what happened, there are two ways you can remove the table, but actually they have some difference. One is drop table, another one is truncate table. So what is the difference between a drop table and a truncate table? Truncate table remove the total table, whereas drop table, what it will do, it will remove only the structure, but the table will structure will sorry it will remove the values in the table, but the structure will remain. That is the main difference between these two. Whereas here, everything will be removed, both the structure as well as the data will be removed. Then data manipulation language. Now next comes the language which we can manipulate data. If you want to enter the data, then enter a record, remove a record, modify a record, for all those things we have SQL query. It is data manipulation language. So that is what we say as SQL, structured query language. In structured query language, we have the following command called, if I want to see that information which I have stored in a table, then you can go for select. Select column name from table, then you can give where conditions. So for example, there are so many people in my table. I want to see the people who are above age 18. Then I can give a condition that select column names from the particular table name where age is greater than 18. Like that I can give. So only those people whose age is more than 18 only will be displayed. So I can give in where conditions, I can give a criteria based on which I can extract and see the data. Same way group by. Group by is also one of the conditional giving only. Then having group. Having is similar to where, but it will be applied on group. Then order by, it is mainly for sorting the data. So this is a general syntax of the select statement. Now we'll see a small example. Select store from SV table. See, all these things are optional. But this is, these two are from table, up to this it is compulsory. So here what we see is select store from ST table. When I give store, which means it includes how many columns you have defined, all the columns will be displayed. If I don't want that, then I want only two columns to be displayed, then you have to specify what are all the columns you want to display in this instead of this store. So we will see the example. Select store from ST table means it will display all the columns and all the values in the table. Now suppose I want to see only two, only that student ID and department ID, I can give like this. See here, select student ID, department ID from ST table. So only those two columns are displayed here. Not these two, these two are not displayed. Only this one, this are displayed. And now we can give var class. What is var class? As I said, you can give conditions. Now I would like to display only the records with the department ID 1. See, this is what here. Select store from ST table where department ID equal to 1. So I have to, for any condition, we have to use the column name. So here what happens, it will, this is store means all the columns. And here we have given where department ID equal to 1 means only those record which belongs to the department ID equal to 1 will be displayed. See here, all the columns are displayed, but only the one which is equal to 1 is displayed. So this is what the var class is used for giving the criteria. Okay, the next one is sorting result with order by. Here what happens, you can order the data, that is descending order or in the ascending order. So here you have to give on which order, whether, because there are four columns in this, or more column also will be there, or based on which column you want to order, that you have to give. So select store from table order by. When you don't give it as descending or ascending order, by default it is an ascending order. Okay, so here order by ST name, here we give on which column you want that order by. So when you give order by ST name, now see here it is in an ascending order, 103 107 101 and so on, ST name. See here, G comes before that, Kalaiwani. Yes, it comes in the ascending order. Then select distinct. You can eliminate the duplicate result from the select statement. Suppose some other data is again coming, that can be removed by using the select distinct. So you can exclude the select distinct column name from table name. Then retrieving data in a range. I want to retrieve the data within a range. So far what we have seen, var class equal to 1 or greater than, like that we have. But if I want in between, say for example age between 18 and age between 20, that alone I want to extract means, then you can give using the between class in the var. So here if you see, select column list from table name var column 1 between lower range and upper range, like that you can give. So for example, select store from ST table where student ID between 101 and 103. Here between 101 and 103 is 101 will be displayed, 100 is below 101. So 101 and 103, only two values. So if you see that, you will have this output, 101 and 103. Only these two will be displayed because you have given the condition as between 101 and 103. The same thing can be achieved with the relational operators. That is where column 1 greater than or equal to lower range and column 1 less than or equal to upper range. So how you can give this, get the same result? Where student ID is greater than or equal to 101. Here you have given greater than or equal to 1 and student ID less than or equal to 103. In the case, you will have the same result. Then like operation. What is like operation? It's a fuzzy operation. You can use percentage and underscore. So percentage is a wildcard, allows you to match any string of zero or more characters. So when you give star percentage symbol, zero or more characters, more than one character can be matched. Whereas underscore strictly matches only a single character. So for example, you can see, select student name from ST table where ST name like K means K percentage means those who start with the starting letter will be K. Those who start with K will be printed. So if you see that Krish Alewani, these two are displayed. Suppose I want to strictly match only K and then the next next thing may be any character, but I want only one character means K underscore no data, because each data is of, see here it is 5 characters, it is more than that. If we want only 2 characters, that is first character should be K, the next character can may be anything. So underscore checks only that particular thing. After that, there is nothing is given. So it will display only one. There is no data present. Same way, select department ID from SV table by department ID like 1 underscore, there is no data. Because minimum department ID is what we have. Here we have only one character, but here it is asking for 1 underscore. So empty set. Select ST name from where ST name like K star means it will give after K whatever matches it will be displayed. Then we'll see ID like underscore 02. So the first character can be anything. Oh, the next two character is 02. So if you see that there is no data, so which means 102 is also not in our database. It seems we'll see that this 102 is also not there. So it is giving man empty thing. 102 is not, but underscore 01 we have one, because 101 data is there. So even if it is 1 or 2 or 3, whatever character matches here, it will extract. Then because the next two character must be 01. So those things can be filtered out.